Vanakkam, Adab and welcome. I'm Aditya and you're watching The Indian Atheist. This video is a brief response to a comment by one of our audience who asks, is it okay for an atheist to be a Dalit? This is a trick question, I think. Of course, many atheists are Dalit, but that's not what he's asking. He's asking, I assume, whether it's okay for an atheist to identify as a Dalit if she's a Dalit. The underhandedness of the question lies in calling attention to the fallacious contradiction that it is frowned upon, and rightly so, for upper caste atheists to assert their upper caste identity. While I'm amused, therefore, by the trickiness of the question, the answer is not that tricky at all. It is a resounding yes. It is perfectly fine for an atheist who is also a member of a persecuted group to identify with the broad movement that symbolizes their struggle for emancipation. In some cases, it is indeed possible that such an identity could express itself even more strongly and sharply than her atheist identity. So yes, an atheist who is a Dalit can, and in fact should, proudly identify as a Dalit atheist. To give another example, it is actually quite admirable for an African-American atheist to wear her atheism on one sleeve and her African-American identity on the other. You wouldn't begrudge an atheist her feminist identity, would you? Then why would you begrudge an atheist her Dalit identity? Look, for far too long, the atheist movement in India has largely been driven by upper caste, upper class people who, in the wake of globalization, have readily imported their notions of atheism wholesale from the West, with little willingness to accommodate within the atheist movement the burning concerns of our own society, especially the caste system. This is partly due to our unfounded grievances with caste-based reservations, partly due to class dynamics, and also partly because Hindu-Muslim tensions have always had a way of hogging attention away from the Dalit movement. But whatever the origins of our apathy, the result is that we have successfully and ironically alienated the section of our society that has been traumatized the most by our religion. It is not for nothing that atheism is often derided as escapism or elitism by the Ambedkarite movement, and I don't see how I can blame them for thinking that. We as Indian atheists must cohere and align our aims and objectives with the specific demands of our society, not the Caucasian's society. And this must start with a thorough understanding of the Dalit movement. We have to understand, for starters, that the word Dalit, unlike the word Brahman, is not an expression of utterly unsubstantiated claims of intellectual superiority. Unlike the words Maratha or Rajput, it is not an expression of vacuous bravado. The word Dalit represents a wholly positive movement for freedom, equality, and justice that is in many ways, objectively, one of its kind in the world. But I'm telling you, my friends, we will not appreciate the beauty of this movement if we keep to our own circles. We must unlearn the things our parents taught us and learn from people who have an expertise in this field. We must question the very roots, the very axioms of our understanding of a caste-based society. In the case of the often-cited abuse of caste-based reservations, for example, we must evaluate reliable data sets drawn from samples that are representative of the population rather than basing our judgment on hunches or anecdotal evidence. We must find it in our hearts to conquer our resentment and bitterness towards the lower caste people merely for insisting that they get the opportunities that are rightfully theirs. Maybe I'm naive, but I think we are better than that. Needless to say, an atheist may not identify as a Brahmani atheist or a Kshatriya atheist. That would be pathetic and petty for obvious reasons that I will not dignify with an explicit mention. On a related note, it is also equally ridiculous for an atheist to assert a nationalist identity. But aren't we the Indian atheist? I suppose that an explanation is in order. We call ourselves the Indian atheist because we sincerely endeavor to represent the unique aspects and viewpoints of atheism arising from the socio-political aspirations and struggles of atheists within what is probably the most culturally diverse group of people in the world. These atheists that we hope to be honored to become a voice of are people hailing from the general Indian subcontinent, a large part of which happens to be contained in a geopolitical entity, a nation-state called India, hence the name Indian. We do not most emphatically subscribe to the nationalist patriotic, jingoistic idea of Indianness. We are decidedly not Indian in the sense that Akshay Kumar or Arnab Goswami would say that they're Indians. We are Indians in the sense that Gauri Lankesh was an Indian. We are Indian in the sense that Rohit Vemmala was an Indian. If you're an upper caste, ex-Hindu atheist from India and you don't agree with our views, or if you feel that we don't adequately represent you, then so be it. Enlighten us, engage with us, criticize us, condemn us. But for now, we like where we stand. We've put a lot of thought into it and we are here to stay. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening. Rampa Nandri, Shukri.